Jesus, all our sins and griefs to bear.
I didn't ask, is Chuck okay? Not feeling up the heart. All that thrills my soul is Jesus.
Younger people.
You are the younger people.
I think you are the younger people.
No.
thought, well, there is no younger people here.
And what a thrill it is to know the Lord. It is. Good song. I like the song. More importantly, I'm glad you liked it. How about another song, ladies? Did you feel picked on when I asked you to sing a verse by yourselves?
Yes.
Did you?
Yes.
Well, it was meant to be honoring to you. Do you want us to sing a verse for you?
No, it's fine.
Okay. How about 635?
635 in the blue book. And it's number 19 in the white book. Thank you. like to give glory to his name tonight for something that he has done for you this past week? How about something he's going to do for you in the next week? As I look back there at Dan, are you going to sing glory to his name because he brought somebody into your life?
Yes.
Can we get that on recording now? Oh, I know, you and Kim are going to be happy together. How about anybody, somebody want to give glory to God for? Sheila was telling me she's so thankful to have a turtle.
Oh, sure.
Yeah, Craig.
Yeah, I've been able to have a job delivering food. You know, my dad can go with me on the job.
Oh, excellent. I didn't know that. How long you been doing that?
I've been doing that for about 3 weeks now.
Okay, how's that working out?
Good.
Is he enjoying getting out?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Good for you, man. I'm happy for you. Glory to the Lord.
I'm thinking about getting a job driving the Amish, too.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
How about that?
If I could get a back seat in my car, you know, because I had flea market stuff and I had to take the back seat out, I have to get another one.
Okay.
And I'll be able to haul the Amish once I do that.
Okay. I would tell people a sad story about an Amish lady that left her husband, which you don't hear about very often, but they asked her why she did, and she said because he was driving her buggy. So, I know that's bad. We're happy for you. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. How about somebody else you want to give glory to God for something that God's done?
He gave me some ambition last week. He gave, I thought I would give something.
Now, Chuck tells us, you never rest. He says you're all the time doing something.
I don't ever accomplish anything.
I beg to differ, but we give the Lord glory that he gave you some extra zip this past week. I know Melanie's grateful that he's breathing better. We rejoice with you. Absolutely. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Anybody else?
We don't think of see all the kids we've been seeing in this church.
Amen.
The program they put on this morning was wonderful.
It was. It was. With little kids, they always bless your heart. Little CJ, he's a riot.
He's a character, isn't he?
He is. I'm telling you what, and his voice just carries. It's crystal clear.
He's got that perfect voice.
He does. He does. They're all wonderful. We are, I agree with you. Give glory to God. Anybody else? Something they want to give glory to God for? I'm reminded of the passage of Scripture that, if I'm not mistaken, after they won the Battle of Jericho, they went up to battle the little town of Ai. And we're talking about the children of Israel, and they lost. They lost the battle. And they were kind of blown away because they really expected to capture it without any problem. And, of course, they found out that the reason they lost the battle was there was sin in the camp. The sin in the camp was they were told when they went in to destroy everything, but they didn't destroy everything. Right. One of the men went in there and kept some stuff. Mm-hmm. And but the way that they found out, they had what they called the Urim and Thummim, they separated people and whatnot, and came to find out that this particular man, his name was Achan, he was guilty. And they said to him, give glory to God and tell us what you did. So, you know, giving glory to God may not always be praising, but it might be even confessing up. The man had to confess. He says, well, I did something I shouldn't have. I went in and I kept some gold and I kept some clothing and it's hidden in my tent. And of course, they went and they found it in his tent. And then they said, because you disobeyed, people died as a result of it. And they took him out and killed him. Him and his family destroyed him. So we need to give glory to God for all the blessings of life. I give glory to God that y'all are here tonight. Grateful that we can still get together.
Glory to God for bringing Cheryl and I to this church. It's been 8 years. We got a message from Norm Schwarzbagger 8 years ago, or whenever Jake and Jesse were coming, and he said, hey guys, Jake and Jesse will be at Calvary Baptist. They'd love to see you guys. Because we lived by them when they had the kids, forever ago. And we came that Sunday, and we came back.
Well, we're glad to have you here.
We're glad to be here.
Appreciate your cookies.
Thank you. We, I enjoy baking. So
for those that weren't here this morning, she brought cookies, homemade cookies. What did you make this past Christmas? Was it like 700 dozen?
About 700 dozen.
700 dozen cookies. So they do cookies, they do candy. They've got a real gift in that.
And he bakes.
So, anyhow, we're going to hopefully continue to give glory to God all during this next week. There's a lot of stuff going on, and just pray the Lord continue to meet our needs. He will as we look to Him. As far as announcements that need to be made, we did announce this morning that on June the 4th, 3 weeks from today, we're going to have baptism. And, looking forward to that. But following the baptism, we're going to have a dinner here at the church. And, so mark it on your calendar, and then I think it's a week from the following, from the 5th, it'll be the 12th of June, will be the next game day. So those, I guess, are the two announcements.
Sign-up sheets are back there.
Sign-up sheets are already up there. Any other
things? And if you don't sign up, you can still come.
Yeah, absolutely.
We have plenty of food no matter what.
Absolutely. So, if there are no other announcements, prayer requests, any additional prayer requests other than what we went through this morning? No?
Zach Schoolcraft is having his surgery on Wednesday at UPMC.
It'll be early.
Okay. He's about halfway down the second column.
I don't know whether they're taking lymph nodes out or what exactly the surgery is doing. But
how old is Zach?
No, I'm not sure how old he is.
20-something?
Yeah,
he's 20. In his 20s.
He's got to be in his 20s.
Okay.
He's got young kids.
Okay. And he is battling cancer. They got rid of it once and it did return. Mm-hmm. So keep him in prayer on Wednesday. Any others that you'd like to mention? Keep David in prayer. We did put him on our prayer list. He's been tired, and they're trying to get, you know, the heart checked out, or get an appointment to get the heart checked out. So keep him in prayer. We pray that everything's going to be okay. Do keep Billy in prayer. Any more appointments scheduled anytime soon, Billy?
Tuesday and Thursday.
Tuesday and Thursday. Do you go twice every week?
Yeah, that's what floods in it.
Okay.
That's what floods into my system.
Okay.
Give me some energy in.
Okay. Do keep him in your thoughts and prayers.
We went out and visited Sandra after church today.
Okay.
She's doing better.
Yeah, she's doing pretty well.
Good. Praise the Lord for that.
We took her cookies.
That's nice. Well, let's join together for prayer. Father, we've come to your house tonight, and we do give you glory for everything that you've done. Every day you're doing things for us. Just life itself is a gift, but eternal life is just almost unbelievable. To think that you've got a place prepared for us. We're never going to die. People say, you really believe that? Yeah, that's what Jesus said. He that liveth and believeth me, though you're dead, yet shall you live. And whosoever liveth and believeth me shall never die. And so, Father, we thank you so much that you have given us a promise that we don't need to be concerned about death. So we give glory to you, but we give you glory for the little things in life every day. And it's not just life itself. Father, for every little blessing that you send our way, it could be the sunshine that we're enjoying. It could be the incredible weather that we're enjoying. It could be the fact that we've got vehicles. I know that Craig was talking earlier about, you know, maybe needing to get another vehicle because of this job that he's got. We're blessed that we live in a country that we can have vehicles. It could be, Father, grateful that we have eyeglasses. I was talking with the sort of service with Diana, and she said that she has trouble seeing far away. And I couldn't help but think as we were engaged in that conversation about how many people went through life not being able to see. I don't know exactly when glasses were created, and still around the world there are a lot of people that don't have the advantage of having eyeglasses. So, Father, we give you thanks and give you glory for all the blessings of life. But again, for the really big one, for the gift of your Son, Jesus Christ, the promise of eternal life, and then the gift of your Holy Spirit to give us the assurance that you're still with us. Thank you so much for these. We come tonight and asking your continued blessing, not just upon us, but upon these that you've got listed in the bulletin. And we're asking you, Lord, to please meet their needs. We do pray for Billy. He's a blessing to us. We enjoy having him here. And Father, I know that it's a real concern to him because he's battling cancer. It's three different parts of his body. We do believe you are the great physician, and we're asking you once again to lay your hand of healing upon him. May it be a statement, Father, that people really can look to you, and you do hear and answer prayers. Father, if you choose not to, and I'm not trying to just backtrack, but Father, sometimes you say no. All of us have experienced the heartache of being disappointed. Even Lazarus in the Bible, you know, when he sent for Jesus, Lord, you didn't show up. And yet there was a purpose in it. But our heart's desire, Father, is that you might have mercy and touch Billy and make him well. We pray for David. Don't know what's going on with the tiredness that he's going through. But ask you, Lord, please, give him some good news. And pray that you can renew his energy. Grateful that his mom, especially, felt more energetic this past week. But pray for Chuck. He's not feeling up to par this evening. Please help him to get better. We do pray, Father, that you would be with Zach Schoolcraft as he goes through the surgery on Wednesday. And pray, Father, that he'll be able to get the cancer. And pray that you would once again touch and heal him, cure him, Father. Restore him to health and strength. We do pray for Dan back there. I know I keep mentioning it, but it'll be on this coming Saturday. He's going to get married. And we as a church family pray for him and Kim. And Lord, you'll bless their marriage and give them a long life of happy marriage together. Pray that you'll meet their needs. Father, we just pray that you'll be the other people that we've got listed in the bulletin. I maybe haven't covered everybody that we've talked about. Father, we come to you because we know that you do hear and listen. And we thank you so much for what you do for us. And we're just asking that you would please touch and meet the needs, both the ones that are written down and even unspoken needs on people's hearts. We pray, Father, that you will revive your people everywhere. That there could be revival within churches, that we would understand we need you more. We need to love you more and serve you better. We do pray, Father, for those that are lost, that they would come under conviction and realize their need to get saved. We pray that our country can get turned back to you. Lord, we pray that you bless our Bible study tonight so we have a chance to look at what your word is teaching us. Pray that you might give us open hearts to not only just hear with our ears, but to understand in our hearts how you would have us to live. And pray, Father, that our lives might bring glory and honor to you. Thank you for being our God. Thank you for this time. Please bless and use the remainder of this service